Praise the Lord, greetings in the wonderful name of Jesus to all our dear friends and families all across this nation, around the world, globally. We want to show to you a clip of the New Zealand revival meeting during the general conference. We spoke about the different roles of the angelic, the angels, the different roles of the angels, why they were created. And we want to show to you a little bit of the clip of the day teaching and the revival meeting that have taken place during the general conference in the month of December in New Zealand. But before that, I want to talk to you a little bit about what's going on around the world today. As we are aware right now that we are in the midst of a coronavirus epidemic that has infected the whole world. It brought the whole world into a standstill, and many stores and businesses, you might have known by now, are closed. Unemployment are very high. People could not able to go out, and in some places things are shut. People are not able to go out and get their things except for a few essential things. In India, people are just living day to day by a little means of what they could have to, for the families. They can able to provide for the families. And many stores and businesses are closed. Unemployment are very high. There's a lot of uncertainty, fear in the hearts of people around the world. The frontliners and the hospital staffs are working around the clock to cure and to diagnose and treat for those people that have been infected by this disease. Airports are shut down, planes are not flying anywhere around the world. It is like the world is just crippled by fear and uncertainty. This is what Apostle John claimed it was the last hour during their time. And this is what they talk about, and the apostles began to claim and walk and live in those days. If they have lived those days as the last hour before the coming of the Lord, this could be the last minute of the last hour before the Lord comes. And but the greatest opportunity that God has given to us is that we can able to reach more people through the technology, through the media, through the facility that we have right now. We can able to reach more people than what the apostles could in their lifetime. And but the key is, if we could walk in the footsteps of the apostles to have the same fellowship with the Lord and the authority of the resurrection power, great thing to be, can be accomplished with the true authority of God in our life. We are the generation God has chosen us for this last hour. It could have been the Phoenix generation, it could have been the Wesley generation, it could have been even the Luther's generation or the Azusa Street Revival generation, but God has chosen this generation, that we will be the generation before the coming of Jesus Christ. And it is not a mistake, but we have an assignment that is divine, and we must work while it is still day. Jesus said, the night cometh that no man can able to work. And with this corona pandemic that is going around the world, we could just have a little bit of the glimpse and how when the night comes, no man can work. No man can able to do anything, and we have to work while it is still day. The airports are closed, planes are going nowhere. I can't go nowhere. I cannot get into a plane and go to the nations in Asia and around to bring the gospel, to preach to the multitudes. And this is the hour that, in fact, that's close to the night hour that we are talking about. People always ask me, why are you always pushing so relentlessly? Why are you always going? Why are you always taking the people and the families and the teams, the mission field? Why are you always spending This is the reason why we were pushing so hard, so that we could reach out to the multitude of people while it is still day. For the year of 2019, we thank God that God has given us a harvest of great souls. We saw over 30,000 people being filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. And I was asking the Lord to double the number for the year of 2020. And in fact, for the month of January and February, we have seen over 14,000 people fill the Holy Ghost, but thousands of miracles and healing have taken place. People have been baptized by the hundreds in the precious name of Jesus Christ. It was a wonderful time of harvest, but I believe that God has given a greatest time of opportunity that the church can walk into if we would just mobilize every avenue that God has given to the church and reach out to the multitudes. We could just walk in the midst of a great, great harvest that the Lord had prepared for the church right now.
Authority, it is going to keep what I've given to them until I'm going to come back for them. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. He gave a word there. He said, whatever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatever that you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Praise God. That means not only God have given the keys to us, but He have given to us the power of the spoken word in the spirit realm. When you began to bind, amen, you are releasing the angels. Amen. You are employing and you are deploying the angels to go into the field and to bind those satanic forces, those powers of darknesses, that they will lose whatever influence they have upon mankind. And when you began to lose, amen, praise God, peace and blessing, you began to lose conviction, you lose hunger, you lose thirst, you are releasing the angels. In other words, heavens are deployed to work on the behalf of the church of the living God. Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. If you would turn to the book of Job, but in the book of Job, I think chapter 1, it talks about the Son of Man have to present themselves before the throne at the crack of the dawn. There is a time, there is a season that the Son of Man, we talk about every created angels that will come and present themselves before the throne of God. Before the day begin, that's where the angels will receive the task before the hand of God. When you begin to petition before God, that's why David said, early will I seek thee to see thy power and thy glory. There is a principality when you go before God and you begin to intercede and you begin to, amen, wage war against the kingdom of darkness early in the morning before the sun rise. When God began to receive from your hand, there were angels that are commissioned to work before you. Even before you rise up, or people begin to rise up, the angels are being deployed into your cities, into the place that you're living, to work on the behalf of the kingdom of God. It is so vital that we understand this, that we are not alone in this rulership of the kingdom of God. 100% of miracle take place when you see the pain is just leaving. 10%, 20%, 30%. That means the healing is already working in your body. Start to claim it, start to walk in it. Sometimes you don't know people, God begin to heal them just a certain amount and they feel the pain is gone and they will still wait for a miracle. A miracle and a healing is a total difference. A healing is a process before you walk into a miracle. But from the place of a healing, you need to dance, you need to shout, you need to proclaim, you need to testify that is a healing has taken place. She went back to the doctor. She said, "Doctor, there's something strange is taking place. I never felt like this for over 7 years. Can you please do the MRI?" And the doctor said, "Okay, I will do the MRI." Took her into the office, did all the MRI, took her back to the room, to his office room, made her to sit down and said, "I think, Sandra, you need to come back, maybe probably 2 weeks' time because you see, the mission is not giving a correct, reading. Something's wrong with the mission. You need to come back in about 2 weeks' time." And she said, "No, doctor, I think that something is definitely has taken place in my body. I wanted to do another MRI and just to double confirm because I know something has happened." And she kept on talking and talking and talking. Praise God. While she was talking, faith began to rise in the heart of the doctor. I'm here to tell you, when God gives you a testimony, don't shut it down. You can walk even in the alleys of the devil's territory and you can rearrange even his territory by the amount of faith God has given to you. Even a doctor who did not have a faith began to believe something has taken place. So they took the second time and placed him on the MRI machine. And then the report came. And the doctor came back and said, I think there's something still missing. You need to come back about 2 weeks later. We will do the MRI when you come back." She began to scratch and she sat there for about, scratch her head and began to talk to him and said, "Look, doctor," she said, "I definitely feel something." You see, faith will take you to the place where not only you will experience the miraculous, but also the faith will release you, praise God, for something that others don't have. When God brings you, stop doubting that it has happened to you. And she said, "I will go to the doctor's office, who's opposite, right across the street. I cannot help myself, but I need to get the diagnosis. I need to get the report out. If you're not going to do it, I'm going to go and do it." Okay, she said, "I'll do it one more time for your sake." They went in and they took the report, and he marched very furiously, very angry, came back to the room, put that report on that wall and began to scream on top of his head. He said, "You know and I know you had a cancer, a 4th-stage cancer. 2 years ago, we went inside your lungs and we removed, there were still traces of cancer. But I looked to that cancer, all the cancer cell is gone." But this is what the doctor said. The doctor said, "You know and I know, we removed the 3 bones to go inside. Tell me, where did you get the new 3 bones? Hallelujah! That is a shouting material, people of God. That is a shouting and rejoicing material. Our God is able, is able, is able. Praise God. I do not know about you, but those kind of testimonies set me, lift me up in the place of praise and dancing and magnifying that He is the Lord of all. He is none other. He is the only one. Praise God. Could you lift your hands and the power of resurrection would be released, that whoever they touch and come across this handkerchief, God, there'll be healing, there'll be miracle, there'll be a breakthrough. God, a greater miracle will be released as this handkerchief be placed upon their hands in Jesus' mighty name. Let it be done right now, Lord.
I worship your holy name, you're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find.
and say, tonight when I come, I'll pray for my hand, no more pain.
Many of you are going to go back home and realize that the Lord has touched you. When that has been happened, praise God, I want you to come back and give Him the glory. Because the Bible says, they overcame Him by the blood of the Lamb and by the testimony of their mouth. Praise God. There is no...
The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the
Please stay tuned to this page. Please enroll to the page called the Gateway to the Supernatural. Amen. Praise God. There's going to be a lot of online teaching, weekly questions. We're going to apostolic authority. We're going to talk about things like the three levels of God anointing, the restoring the fivefold ministry, spiritual warfare series, the ranks and roles of angels, how to embrace deliverance and healing ministry in the last days, the power of binding and loosing, the power of the spoken word of Rhema, the three offices of authority in the Old Testament that links to the apostolic fivefold ministry. There are many topics that we're going to talk, and not only we're going to teach, but we're also going to open up a session where we are going to partake and discuss. There's going to be people that are enrolling into this page. In fact, at the moment, we already have 100 of people, and this is a platform of teaching, and please sign up. It's called the Gateway to the Supernatural, and it's supposed to be a school, but it's a ministry right now. We want to prepare, we want to empower the body of Christ. God is about to do in the coming days after the pandemic is over. I believe that we are about to step into the greatest harvest that God has prepared for the church, and we don't want to miss the assignment, we don't want to miss the calling, we don't want to miss the opportunity that God has prepared for this church for such as a time as this. The Lord bless you. Let's pray right now. God, even in this moment, we pray that you will embrace every of people that have been infected by those viruses. And I pray right now that Jesus, God, you bring forth your healing upon them, bring forth your restoration power. Lord, I'm asking you for all those that have lost their job. I pray, provide them, sustain them. Jesus, let there be a miraculous way that you're able to provide and sustain your people. For you are Jehovah Jireh, you are the provider. I'm asking you to touch your people, open the doors and provide them as you provided in the days in the Old Testament and the New Testament. For God, you are the provider, Lord. And I pray, surround your people. Let there be age of protection around your people in this last day. Protect them, God, from this virus that's going around. And I pray, raise up a great army and a force of a mighty, mighty group of apostolic that reach out to the lost world in this last day for your name, in Jesus' name. Amen.
The sun comes up, it's a new